Hello world, this is Plovit, and I am here to show you my method for opening a Masterlock padlock. This is a Masterlock padlock that I have bought September 2013, so it's brand new. And I know there's many videos on YouTube on how to open a Masterlock padlock. I happen to have come up with my own method, which I think is better, quicker, and probably easier than the other ones. You don't have to write any numbers down. You can open a padlock in 1 to 2 minutes with a little bit of practice, and you can actually feel the combination instead of mathematically calculating it. So the method goes in the following. First, I want you to have a little bit of practice in feeling the padlock. So we have the shackle here, and we'll do a little bit of exercise in feeling the tension in the padlock. Second will be to actually find the first number. Then we will find the second number, and finally we will find the third number of the combination and open the padlock. So if you're feeling the padlock and getting used to it, you kind of put your finger through the shackle and put a little bit of tension on the shackle, and you will see that it locks into position. In this case, the padlock is locking between two numbers. It doesn't really matter which numbers they are. And if I let up a little bit of tension, I can jump over to the next slot where it locks between two numbers and jump to the next number and keep going around until you get this hang of jumping between two numbers, locking it and jumping to the next number. If you can't jump, you have too much tension in your shackle, and if you don't feel the actual locks, you don't have enough tension. So do that for a while until you've got a little bit of play and practice and a little bit of feeling. About every four numbers, you should find a little locking position. Now we're ready to actually find the first number. The first number is very easy to find. It's probably the hardest step of the whole process. You put a very slight amount of tension in the shackle, and you turn it. You shouldn't feel anything for most of the way around. If you're feeling the bumps of each and every number, every four numbers, you're pulling too hard. Just a little bit of tension, and there I feel some pressure. Click, I went right over it. And I can continue turning here, and I don't feel anything happening on the padlock until I get right back to that zero here on my padlock. There's a little bit of tension. Click, I went over it. Now if you pull too hard on your shackle, you'll basically be hitting each and every number as you go around. You have a really rough and bumpy way around, so yeah, that's too much tension. If you don't have enough tension, you just spin and nothing will happen. So you have to put just enough tension on the padlock so you hit one single bump on every turn around. It's a very small amount of tension. There's my bump right there. And if I stop it where I'm feeling that bump, that's the indication of my first number. In this case, it's stopping at zero. So add five to that number, and for some reason, magic reason, that's your first number, five. So reset your dial, put a clean five on, and we're ready to go for the second number. The second number is found by turning the opposite way with more tension and feeling each and every bump until you can't go any farther. Now I happen to know, as with all padlocks, you have to go around your five at least one time. So I'll just jump forward this first spin back to five. And now I will start feeling the bumps. Put more pressure, more tension in the shackle than you had beforehand, and spin around. If you can't get over the bumps, you have too much tension, find a kind of a medium amount of tension, and you'll bump over each of the numbers. Bumpity, 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 bump. And keep going around. You go at least one time around, probably a little bit more. There goes the five again. Bumpity, bump, bumpity, bump. Bumpity, bump, bumpity, bump. Bumpity, bump. And I have reached a kind of wall. Now, if I let go of the shackle, of course, I can move this wall too, but this one is noticeably harder to get across than the other walls were. So I have now basically reached my second number, and it's stuck somewhere here between 31 and 32. So one of those, 31 and 32, is my second number. All I have to do now is find the third number. So I dial in my 5, make sure the padlock's reset, everything's just the way it needs to be, 5. Dial in my 31, 31 and a half, 32, whatever it was. And now we will go through and find the last number. The last number is found very simply by just testing possible combinations down the way. So I subtract 2 from the number I have, so 32 minus 1 would be 30. And afterwards, I continue on with 4. So 30 minus 4 is 26, test it. 26 minus 4 is 22, test it. 22 minus 4 is 18, test it. 18 minus 4 is 14, test it. And I've now opened my padlock. That will take you probably not even a minute if you get a little bit more practice. So it doesn't take 1 or 2 minutes. Step 1 was finding the first number 5 by looking for a small bump, a little bit of light tension in the shackle, and look for one single bump on every single turn. Afterwards, you look for the second number. You do that by feeling each and every bump until you hit a large wall that you can't go over. And that is your second number. And the third number you find by simple process of testing. Reduce it by two for the very first guess on the third number, and then keep going down by jumps of 4 until you actually open it. That's it. That's all it is. Scarily simple, to be honest. So now you have the power to open any Masterlock padlock that you have. Please use it wisely. Please do not steal anything from anyone. Please use it only for fun. I personally find it very amusing, very interesting to be able to do it. But don't think it's proper to do anything you're not supposed to do. I will give a caveat and say I did it for the first time myself yesterday. I will give the caveat and say I have only this one single padlock to work on, so it may be that it's slightly different other padlocks, but I do not believe so. Please let me know if you have any comments, any successes, and I wish you luck. Thank you. Goodbye.